Hi, and welcome to Home Assistant How-To with Bearded Thinker. Today we will be integrating Xiaomi and Roborock robot vacuums inside Home Assistant. We'll start in 10 seconds. As always, before we go any further, I really would like to thank all the members who have joined my channel. Thank you very much, your support really means a lot. And also, if you still haven't subscribed, please subscribe and hit the bell button so you get notified on the future updates. And if you like this video, give me a thumbs up, because it means a lot to me, but also to YouTube algorithms. Thank you. Plan for today's video is to install or integrate various Xiaomi or Roborock based robotic vacuums inside Home Assistant. And the integration is now much more easier than it was 3 months, 6 months or a year ago. So we will be going through the whole setup. First, we will be retrieving the token. Second step will be to add the integration itself to Home Assistant. And in the third step, we will be adding information like this, or this live map, or even if you're interested, this one that allows you not just to see where the robot is, but also to select zones or redirect it somewhere else. So what are the things that you will be needing today? First of all, you need to have Mi Home app. This will not be working with the Roborock app. So install Mi Home app and add your vacuum there. As I said previously, you will need to have Mi Home app and you need to get the user ID or the username and password for this app. The second step that you need is the IP address from the robot itself, because we will be needing this username or user ID and password combined with the IP address to retrieve the token. For the first step, you need username and password for the Mi Home app where you added your robot. This robot can be either Xiaomi or it can be Roborock. If you do not have username for your application and instead you may be using your phone number as a username, then you have to get the user ID from the application. It's really simple. All you need to do is go to the settings, click on your profile, and there you will see your user ID for the application. So wherever you see username and you do not have username, you can use this user ID. Okay, now let's download the applications. There are three methods, I would say. First one is to use the Python script, and I will not be showing you how to do that, but instead I will show you how to use two applications to retrieve tokens for all of your Xiaomi devices. So let's first download the script. Piotr Machowski really did a great job for the community with overall stuff he did for the Xiaomi or Roborock vacuum cleaners. One of the things he did is the Xiaomi-cloud-tokens-extractor. This is a simple command line tool. You just have to download this token-extractor.exe file. But this can also be run inside the Docker. On the other hand, you can also try and install it here by hand, but as I said, I will not be covering that because we want to simplify the process. So when we download the token extractor, let's start it. After you start the application, next step for you is to specify either username or the user ID from the Mi Home app. Let me quickly type it in. Press enter. And now type in your password. The third and the last step of the process to retrieve token is to specify what server your application is using. So you may be using China server, US server, European server, but if you are lazy like me and you do not want even to bother and think where your data is located, you can just hit enter and it will check all the available servers. And here it is. I have data on the Chinese server, used for my Xiaomi mosquito repellent. Then I also have a German server, which is also a European server, where I have my Wi-Fi repeater, my Roborock, and also my little pony, which is M365 scooter. So in this step, what we need to do is copy this token here, and we will be needing it later on, in a couple of integrations, to set up our system. So copy it and save it somewhere safe. But as I said, there are two applications that you can use to retrieve token. The second one is called Get Mi Home Device Token. So let's download this application. For that, we will go to Releases and select Current Version. The current version at the time of the recording is 1.0.2. And after the file has finished downloading, what you have to do, you have to extract, and there will only be one file inside the zip folder. Just start it. When you start it, you will be presented with a screen like this. Once again, type your username or user ID, and of course your password. Press sign in. Pretty quickly, you will be presented with a screen showing you all the tokens for all the devices that have been added to Mi Home app. What we are interested in is this information here. Copy it and store it in a safe place. And while you're here, you can also check the IP address of your robot because, as I said, we will need the IP address too later on. These are the two tools that will help you retrieve the token, not just for the Roborock or Xiaomi vacuum robots, but also for all the other devices that you have added to your Mi Home app. So remember, if in the future you need to add gateway or things like that, this is where you can retrieve this token. Okay, now the first step is done. The second step is to add the robot itself to the Home Assistant. Inside Home Assistant, go to Configuration, Integrations, click on a plus sign to add integration, and type Xiaomi Mio. You have to specify the IP address. And we have to paste here the token that we copied previously. You can now submit, and if everything is okay, you will have Home Assistant connected directly to your vacuum cleaner. If we scroll down, we can see here that we have added Roborock Vacuum S5e. E presumably stands for the Max, because this is the version I have. Let's click on Device. As you can see, we only have one entity here. It's called Roborock Vacuum S5e. So we can now add it to our Home Assistant Lovelace UI. And now we can add our robot here. Entities. So here, now we have a simple integration that is showing us the status of the robot. If I would, for example, start it, you would see that the status changed from idle to cleaning. And if we click here, and here you can see all the information that the robot is providing to our system. You can change the vacuum speed. You can start it, pause it, stop it, go to a specific spot, locate it on the map, or return home. Here you have information about the current cleaning process and the total cleaning time, and this information can be used for automations to warn you when, for example, you need to clean the sensor or replace the main brush or side brush. Also, if your robot supports it, here you will have information if the mop is attached or not. And yes, currently for my robot it is attached. Let's pause it. The next step for us is to add better visual representation. We will start with something like this, then we will be adding this dynamic map, and the last step for us will be to add this map that allows you also to control and send your robot either to zones, to targets, or things like that. So let's get started. First things first, let's add this to our Home Assistant. This integration can be added through the HACS. Of course, you can also manually add it, but I will not even bother showing you because I really do think that everybody should have HACS inside their system because it simplifies the process of adding additional either integrations or Lovelace add-ons. So let's go to HACS. As this is a front-end integration, let's click on front-end, explore and add, and type here Xiaomi. And here we have simple vacuum card. Let's press on install, install, and reload. And this is it. Now let's go back to overview, robots, add a dashboard, add cart. And in order to add this to Lovelace, let's scroll down and either here select basic configuration or use this one, which is more advanced. This one allows you to also have the background image. If we use this one, copy, manual card, and here replace this with the name of our robot. And this is what you will see now inside your Home Assistant. Of course, if you're interested and want to have prettier or nicer graphics, you can also specify the background image. Now we have added our robot the simplest way, by using integration. We also added this information card. But how do we add this? These are the two additional HACS components that you can retrieve from the HACS store. So let's go once again back to HACS. And since this cloud map is integration, we have to go to integrations. But if you try to edit from here and type cloud, you will not see it here. So let's close this. Let's click on the three dots, add custom repositories, paste the URL, which you can get either from the GitHub page or you can find it in the description of the video. And for the category, select integration and click on the add. We now have Xiaomi Cloud Map Extractor added. Let's close this, press on explore, Xiaomi Cloud Map Extractor, and press here install. But before we restart our system to finish HACS integration installation, let's go to our configuration YAML file. I'm using VS Code, but you can use any other tool that you are normally using to edit your configuration. Let's scroll down to camera section. And if you do not have cameras already, you just add camera, column. And here we will paste code from the GitHub repository. Let's go back to GitHub. And there are a couple of ways on how to integrate it, but I will not be using basic. I will be using instead recommended setup. So let me copy this. The difference between the basic and the recommended one is that in the recommended one, you draw all, meaning that everything will be drawn on the map, and the system will automatically create calibration points. This is something that is not included in the basic configuration. So copy it and paste here the code. Okay, everything is as it should. And now you just need to add to your secrets file Xiaomi Vacuum Host. This is the IP address of your vacuum cleaner. Token, Xiaomi Vacuum Token. This is the token that we retrieved previously. And your username and password that you use to access your Mi Home account. As I said, username can be either username or user ID. Let me quickly do that. I've now fixed my secrets YAML file and I've added host, token, username, and password inside of it. And now we have to restart our system. After we restart our system, a new camera will be created and this camera will be showing us all the time, in the real time, the information from our Mi Home app or the map where the robot is currently located. Let's go to configuration, server control, and if everything is okay, let's press on restart. If you did like this video so far, please consider giving me a thumbs up. Thumbs up not only means a lot to me, but it also helps YouTube create additional algorithms and recommend my videos to other viewers that like similar content as you. Thank you. And in order for us to add this, let's go to robots, three dots, click on add, picture entity, select here Xiaomi Cloud Map Extractor, and let's press save. And you will now have a simple but efficient map showing you where currently your robot is located. Okay, a bit of disclaimer. So, this one will show you the current map. Unfortunately, at this point, if you are running your robot in a multi-floor setup like I am, you are unable to select here what floor map you want to show. It will only show you the current map floor from the Mi Home app. So there are currently only two ways to show the current map. First one is to move the robot and press start vacuuming on it. And after it positions itself, it should show you the current map. The second one, if you want to show map before you start cleaning, is to move robot physically. And then also in the Mi Home app, select the map for the floor where your robot is currently located. That way, you would be able to send the robot to a specific location via Home Assistant. Yeah, the author is aware of this, and as far as I know, there are currently two enhancements open on the GitHub as issues, where in one we will be able to select the map, and in the other we will be able to also configure zones. But when we are already talking about zones, as you can see here we do not have ability to select a zone or a room for cleaning, and also to send our robot there. In order for you to add this, you need to add additional integration. And this integration is also from the same author, but unfortunately you have to add this integration by hand. So let's go to GitHub first. This integration from Piotr Machowski allows you to navigate robot by using the map from within Home Assistant. It allows you to select zones, to predefine zones, to send also the robot by using the position here on the map. But in order for us to add this, we have to add this by hand. We have to retrieve four files called Xiaomi Vacuum Map Card, Coordinates Converter, Texts and Style JSON Scripts. And since I'm lazy to do it with the virtual machine I have, there is an alternative way on how you can do that. We have to go to Visual Studio Code. In Visual Studio Code, we first have to create folders. So you have to have www. Then inside this folder, you need to create additional folder called Custom Lovelace. And inside Custom Lovelace folder, we have to create a new folder called Xiaomi Vacuum Map Card. Enter. So here we now have to create or copy four files. As I said, I'm lazy to do it by hand by using Samba, so I will be creating them through the Visual Studio Code. First file I will be creating will be called Xiaomi Vacuum Map Card.js for JavaScript. New file, paste it here. The next file will be called Coordinates Converter. So new file, Coordinates Converter. Third file will be text.js, and the fourth file will be style.js. So we now have three empty files, and what I'll do, I'll just simply copy the raw contents of the files from the GitHub to these files here. We go to dist for distribution, open style, select raw, control A or select all and copy, and inside Visual Studio Code, inside the style.js, we just paste the contents of that file. Save it. And let's repeat this for other three files. All four files have now been created and the content has been copied. So we have Xiaomi Vacuum Map Card, Coordinates Converter, Texts and Style. Next, we have to add this to our Lovelace, and we do this by copying this path here. And inside the Home Assistant, we go to Configuration, Lovelace Dashboards, Resources, Add Resource, paste the URL and leave this as JavaScript model, Create. Let's go to Overview, Robots, press Ctrl F5 to clear the cache of the browser. And in order for us to add this finally to Lovelace UI, we click here, Add Card, Manual, and you can paste the sample from the GitHub. Just make sure to adapt this and change the entity to match the entity ID of your robot vacuum, and also map camera to match your camera that you now have inside your system. Also, these zones, these have been copied from the GitHub page, so you will need to adapt this and get the right zones for your system. Let me quickly replace this with the name of my vacuum. And for now, I will not be touching zones. Let's press save. Let's close this. And as you can see, you now have option to control your robot, not just to see where it is located, but to control it on map. Let's, for example, press on go to target. Let's set target here and press start. The robot itself should now move to that location. Of course, the first step for the robot is to position itself, so it can take a couple of seconds for this to finish. And as you can see, the robot itself is now slowly moving to the position I selected. You have, of course, other options. You have zone cleanup, Zones, but as I still haven't fixed Zones, I'm unable to use it currently through Home Assistant. This type of integration will work for various Xiaomi and Roborock robots, but unfortunately there are a couple of robots that are not supported. If you have this model, it's called STYJ02YM, then there is an additional GitHub repository that you can visit and integrate it inside Home Assistant, because this is unfortunately one of the robots that currently is not available through this integration. And this is it for this Home Assistant how-to with Bearded Thinker. I really do hope that you enjoyed this video, and I really do hope that you have a lot of fun with integration of your Xiaomi and or Roborock robots inside Home Assistant. Of course, now you are free to do various things. For example, you can create notifications that will send you warnings if your usage for the brush or the sensor has fallen below some kind of threshold. Then, if you have some kind of alerts and you can get those alerts inside Home Assistant, you can intercept the alerts and send notification either to speakers or to your mobile phone. Yes, and there are also possibilities to schedule your robot to do various tasks if everybody leaves the house. So it's all up to you. There are tons and tons of things you can do with this, and I really do hope that you will have fun with them. But as I said, this is it for this Home Assistant how-to. I really do hope that you enjoyed this video. I really do hope that you find something here useful. If you still have any kind of a comment or a question in regard to this video or any previous video I did, you can always find me on the Discord server. But feel free to leave a message down in the comment section here too. If you still haven't subscribed, please subscribe and hit the bell button so you get notified of future videos. If you did like this video, please give me a thumbs up because it means a lot, not just to me, but also to YouTube algorithms. And I'll be seeing you next time. Until then, bye bye and have fun.